time to do this thing. I'm going to introduce our judges. I need you guys to go nuts for them. Are you ready? Coming out of the back. Oh, I lied to you. Stupid short guy. Before we introduce our judges, folks, put your eyes on the screen next to you for a quick sizzle reel. Here we go. Psych. Why don't we see this IRL, all right? So let's do this right now. We're gonna be introducing our judges, clap and cheer and go nuts. I'm coming right now, costume designer for Marvel's Defenders, Luke Cage, Daredevil, Jessica Jones, and many, many more. Clap and scream for Stephanie Maslenska! Here we go, folks. She's a judge on Sci-Fi's Cosplay Melee. Clap and cheer for Leanna Van! SVP for Singer Song, give it up for Kelly Hall! Young lady is an actress and the founder of Her Universe. Clap and scream for Ashley Eckstein! Quick word here from our sponsors. Folks, are you in the market for some sugar-free, vitamin and antioxidant fortified, delicious, mesmerizing energy? Well, look no further than G Fuel, the official drink of New York Comic-Con. And I'm not getting paid for this, but Kohl's has generously donated prizes for the category winners, a variety of patterns and notions, and they'll be distributed after the show at the pickup room. And last but not least, here's this from Singer. This year's prize is graciously sponsored by the Singer Sewing Company, who has been the premier partner for cosplayers to begin their own sewing journey with easy-to-use and affordable sewing machines, as well as free tutorials and projects available on their website. Singer is proud to be an integral part of cosplay community, enabling cosplays around the globe to bring their vision to life and participate in this incredible culture. Please hold. Give our sponsors a big round of applause. Everybody, big round of applause for
them. That's right. Without them, we wouldn't be here.
That was a lot of words.
Yeah.
Thank God I talked.
I like how it folds down.
I know, they made sure I got all the words in. All right, yeah. Folks, it's time to do this thing. It's time to introduce our cosplayers, all right? But before we do that, I want to talk to the judges. Judges, ladies, first of all, we got a panel full of lady judges, which is awesome. This is fantastic. This is fantastic for me. I don't appreciate the way y'all segregated the pretty people and the ugly people on the stage. I don't appreciate the way we did this.
Red Rover, send Ashley Eckstein over.
Okay. Creepy, stop it. All right, here we go. So ladies, we're gonna have a lot of folks back there who are waiting to come out here and show you their stuff. So we really wanna know what you guys are going, what's going through your head right now. In fact, like you said, Ashley, what are you looking for tonight?
Ooh, well, we had the chance to prejudge earlier, so we got to see all the costumes. And let me tell you what, y'all, we don't know. It's so hard. All the costumes are amazing. It's such a close race. So, yeah. What? Okay, I don't know, but you're in for a treat. The costumes are awesome.
He said, "I'm happy." Yeah. Don't worry about it. That's what he said, okay? Yeah. That's all he said. All right. And Stephanie, what are you looking for tonight?
I'm rooting for all of them. I think they're all fantastic, and I'm really looking forward to how they do their performance on stage. That will make a big difference, because we saw an incredible amount of talent and creativity today. It's going to be a real tough call.
And moving over here to Leanna. Leanna, cosplay is your is how you make your money, all right? So how hard is it for these folks to come up on this stage and show you this?
I was just going to say that. Let's give a round of applause to everyone that's going to be coming up on the stage right now. They're all back there right now. They can hear you. They're going to feed off your energy. It takes extreme guts to get up here in front of you guys. So like Ashley said, you guys are in for a huge treat. So be prepared.
That's what I like to hear. Last one, I come on over to Kelly. Kelly, you're the boss of a sewing company. All right. So you got a lot of folks in the back. What are you looking for today?
Everything back there is amazing. And I think we're going to need your help. So let us know what you think.
Yeah, let's try to do this. In fact, I think we should get things started. You guys ready to get things started? Let's do this thing. Coming out first, this is our armor class. Coming out on stage right now, clap and scream for Jamal Johns coming in as Superman Lex. Everybody, Superman Lex, come on out here. Superman Lex from DC Comics Rebirth series, with the disappearance of Superman, Lex Luthor declares himself the new Man of Steel. He created the armor in about 3 months, pouring out at least 100 hours into it. He made it out of EVA form, LEDs, and painted it with red and blue glitter blasts of paint. And I personally think he did a fantastic job. So please give Superman Lex a big round of applause. One more time, give him a big round of applause, everybody. Big round of applause for him. Coming out next from Iron Hills Forge, give it up for Lady Thor. Keep it going, people, keep it going. There you go. Lady Thor was constructed using EVA form, craft foam, insulating foam, faux leather, and fur. This took over a year to assemble. The knot work was created by drawing onto a form of freehand style and knot knifing with detail and form. The paint job involved over a dozen shades of silver, ranging from sterling silver to brushed nickel. Put a lot of hard work and detail in this outfit. Please, one more time, give Lady Thor a big round of applause. Next is Kevin Uribe as Medieval Spawn. The Medieval Spawn armor took approximately 1,000 hours. I'm going to say this again. Whoa. Yes. The plywood center, the light in the helmet, the cape, and the collar are both dyed red and distressed. The remaining details are made of varying materials, EVA form, plastic, leather, and wood. Again, I got to say this. This man took 1,000 hours to construct this thing, all right? Yes. 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 That's what I'm talking about. Give him a big round of applause, everybody. Yes. Looks like a Snoop Dogg concert up here. All right, so coming out next is Ginoza Cosplay coming in as Yoshimitsu. Tanya is a performer from Columbus, Ohio, and has been making costumes since 2010. Her costume was well hand-painted and included the flag on her back, which is the two identical paintings done directly onto fabric. The double masks were hand-sculpted and fitted to a warbler. She has constructed a robot form with fully articulated. The armor pieces are full self-patterned. It took Brittany roughly 250 hours to construct this costume. I mean, everything about that is fantastic. That is one good-looking costume. You are not getting through TSA, but that is a great costume right there, okay? Coming out next is Pepper Monster Cosplay as Diana Prince. This is from the Wonder Woman movie. The bodice is made out of hand tool cut dyed leather, wet molded. The golden armor is made from warbler. Every detail hand etched in the surface. The skirt and harness are real leather as well. The shield is EVA form and magnetically attached to the harness. The sword is formed leather. Four dragon heads were hand-sculpted with all the runes in carve. The boots are fully articulated and lined and made of warblers. Literally made this costume head to toe. Give her a big round of applause, everybody. Go over there.
Excellent job.
All right, folks, coming out next. And random white girl coming out. Coming out next. MJ cosplay as the Red Ranger. It's morphin' time. It took 6 months, about 420 hours, using my own templates to make the armor, use EVA form, craft foam, and then the use Warbler to cover everything. Use spray paint for a base and acrylic paint for the detailing. Use a fine art marker for all the line work by hand. Okay. Did all the line work on paint by hand, my friends. Use small string LED lights for each lighting piece on spine and chest and fabric. Once again, folks, MJ cosplay as Red Ranger. It's afraid. He dropped down. I thought he was going to do a split. I was crying. All right, coming out next, unorthodox design as Orcish Wasteland Raider. Give him a big round of applause, everybody. From Fallout, the Raider's armor features a massive neuro-control power claw. This causes his pupil to be constantly dilated. Water is also provided to his mask. He never takes it off. Adorning this armor, many relics and trophies for the past battles. Being a close combat specialist, he has been in more than a few fights. This thing is absolutely fantastic. What you guys got to see is right up close. Everything is movable. Everything is fantastic. I mean, even all the way down to the boots. Oh, yes. When is the last time you've seen a Wasteland Raider twerk on stage? This was the last time you saw that. One more time, give a big round of applause, everybody. Big round of applause. Coming up next is Shining Polaris as Rocket Raccoon. There you go. Christine Diab is Shining Polaris as a cosplayer from Chicago and for the group The Age of the Geeks. She's cosplaying as Rocket Raccoon from Guardians of the Galaxy. The bodysuit is handmade and dyed and hand-painted multiple times to look weathered. All the trim, belt, and pouch is faux leather. The armor is made out of EVA form. The gun is made from parts from a Nerf gun. Assembled together in foam cardboard. It's time for this hell. This costume took 3 months to make. Just it's a lot of something about the tail. There you go. Coming out. It's a lot of twerking happening on this stage. I don't know what's happening this year. All right. Coming out next is Rattle and Burn as Sylvana's Windrunner. Big round of applause, everybody. This costume carries over 15,000 chainmail rings. I'm going to say this again. This costume contains over 15,000 chainmail rings, as well as a hand-dyed leather resin Warbler LED dice, and is made over the course of 3 months. You really got to get up on that one. That was a fantastic job. Give her a big round of applause, everybody. Up next, we have Outlaw 2LK coming as Power Rangers Megazord. Law's been coming to NSC Cup since 2006. It wasn't until 2015 that he decided to take cosplay to the next level. He made an 8-individual costume for NYC this year, the same year. Last year, his first attempt using EVA form as well received, and he entered his first Eastern Championship of Conley, winning first in his division last year and second overall with his 7-foot-tall Voltron. This year's 8-foot-tall Power Rangers Megazord was compiled in 66 hours. That only took 66 hours to make from him, which is ridiculous to me. And it spread over 20 days. A painter, stilts, PVC pipes, and most of the costumes were made from EVA form. Once again, folks, Outlaw 2LK as Power Rangers Megazord. Here we come is Katie Stella cosplay as Elwyn from Lord of the Rings. Bigger round of applause, everybody. The chainmail is 9 pounds of aluminum rings constructed piece by piece by hand. The vests, braces, and helmets are foam made with various techniques such as texturizing, paint, and caulk mixing. The sword and sheath are combined of foam and thermoplastics. Warblock, Hydex, and Mikasa was started right after New York Comic Con 2016. And completed this time and then the convention. Nice job. Give her a big round of applause, everybody. There you go. And that, my friends, was our armor division. Get them all in the back. A big round of applause. Ladies, I am comfortable in saying I don't want your job. You guys have a lot of stiff competition back there. There's a lot of, for folks that don't know, any one of you, explain to folks what EVA foam is or Warblood. Explain it so folks out there know what it is.
So EVA foam is essentially, it's like floor matting. You can get it at a hardware store. So a lot of these costumes that you saw on stage are made out of foam. And you guys probably couldn't tell. It probably looks like metal or looks like wood or whatever they're trying to transform it into. But if you touch it, it's very lightweight. So the amount of skill to do that is insane. And I mean, what do you guys think?
Yeah. Thank you for that. Let's keep this thing going. This is our needlework competition. Give these folks a big round of applause. Coming out for us is Mink the Satyr as Ninetales. Mink the Satyr as Ninetales. Big round of applause for Mink the Satyr is a Boston-based cosplay best known for her elaborate Pokemon cosplay. Mink patterned her Ninetales costume from scratch using real cow and pig leathers. Each piece of the armor has been hand-cut, carved with tools. She hand-stitched her corset and saddlebag with two needle-stitch technique. Her tails and headdress are made from faux fur with LED panels. Mink made her eyeball or Pokeball axe with EVA, PVC, craft foam, Warbler, and googly eyes. Just to give it a little bit of a hit, one more time, give it up for Ninetales. Coming out next, we have Albino Shadow as Amira. This is a setting of the bride story manga from the Turkish region. During the 19th century, drove every decision made during her. Materials were chosen, and garment patterns drive it based on extensive research into the Ottoman costume history. This embodies the embroideries alone took hundreds of hours and were meticulously carried out by hand using technique of metal threads and sequins. To put this in perspective, each gold work embroidered sleeve took 20 hours to complete. And I think she did a fantastic job. Give it up for Amira. Very scary. Very scary. There you go. Yeah, she was. All right, coming out next. Charles Battersby as Disney Princess. It's fantastic. So many princesses, too few Comic-Cons. What a Disney princess to do. Charles loves Cinderella. Charles loves Cinderella and Belle from Beauty and the Beast. So how can one person possibly cosplay both at once? Thanks to a little help from a fairy godmother with a little kindly enchantress, Charles found a way. The design took two historical ball gowns patterns and was crunched with satin and brocade, along with an assortment of shiny things gathered by helpful forest creatures. Two princesses at once. One more time, give them a big round of applause. Coming on as we have Jillian cosplays as Crystal Maiden. Crystal Maiden cosplay took 6 months to create and about a year before that to find all the perfect materials. The dress is entirely hand-painted onto an iridescent dark blue stress taffeta. With over 8 hours of work on the white detailing alone, all the pattern used was drafted by myself to regain the accurate to the game. Marvel took 7 bottles of nail polish to paint the top gem of the staff. I think she made a great choice. One more time, give it up for Crystal Maiden. Coming up next, we have Janna Kuchera as Bodhi Rook from Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. Skiles of Bill is 9 months in the making and proven to be quite the undertaking. Every pocket was custom crafted and sewn with each little hole as a place of its own. The backpack consists of cardboard and PVC. This edition foam. The googles are last and complete the Rook. That's all there is, but maybe now you'll see that there's more to this pilot known as Riz MC. Big round of applause, everybody. Nice job.
That's funny.
Coming up next, we have Shikarius as Mabel Taylor, the world of the Mystic Wiz. Big round of applause, everybody. Mabel is over 900 hours of my life, and I'm never getting it back. She's in 15 yards of hand-dyed sock, 3 kilometers embroidery thread, over 3,000 hand-sewn beads, swarovski crystals, and a bullion sequence. The costume was patterned from scratch. Once again, the costume was patterned from scratch, which required a full refresher in high school geometry and 3 blood sacrifices. Clap and scream for Mabel Taylor. Coming out next, we have Vorentaris as Ray. Ray is a scavenger that lands alone in the heart of Deathless. The costume has been in development since before the premiere of The Force Awakens in 2015. In true Skywalker fashion, it has been adjusted, had parts replaced, and been repaired over and over in effort to replicate Ray's iconic costume. Exactly. The cloth and soft props are custom dyed. Her backpack is leather, and the staff constructed from 3D prints, resin, and plastic. Like Ray, this cosplay is ready to take on anything. One more time, give it up for Ray. Pretty damn good. She had that look. All right, coming out next, we have Paul Okazaki as Winter Soldier. There you go. Hi, I'm the Biggie Bucky Stint in a Soviet Russia. According to the now-changed storyline, he was presumed dead, but later revived into the Winter Soldier by Hydra. Say the time period is 1960 until his recapture in 1970. Uniforms hand-stitched with pictures as my guide. TV friendly, if I may add, with the exclusion of badges and insignias, as I don't want to promote any Soviet propaganda. Total time to complete this, 6 months. One more time, give it up for the Winter Soldier. Coming out next, we have Alchemical Cosplay as Astrologian from Final Fantasy XIV. Whoa. A healer class who uses arcane magic to control fate. The Astrologian's gear required a wide variety of crafting techniques and 7 months to accomplish. Everything from the hat to the gold leaf accessories is unique. The grounds sweeping skirts have a hand. The gyroscopic star globe uses a miniature motor, LED lights, and magnets to achieve its magical effect. And it is magic indeed. One more time, give it up for Alchemical Cosplay as Astrologian. Oh, that's the flair. The flair at the end was nice. Give her a big round of applause. I like the flair. I'm a sucker for some flair. Coming up next, we have Leah London from Go Soul Cosplay as Jacob Fry. Assassin's Creed fans, make some noise. Cosplay from Assassin's Creed are all about the details. Leah not only spent over 6 months alone to quilt the lapels, 6 months alone to quilt the lapels and back panels from a fully leather hide, but the necklace is made from an authentic Victoria, England shilling. All the belting and straps are handmade, and the fabric for the pants was imported from the UK. All the patterns she used were modified or drafted by hand to bring a complete accuracy to the coat. And I think she did a fantastic job. Give it up for Jacob Fry. Coming up next, we have Natalie. I'm going to say this one. Yeah, it is as Sansa Stark. This dress is made out of black sand, the feather detail in the collar and jacket is made from dyed rooster leaves. The dress was sewn on a Brother L221, that's a lot, and the pendant was forged out of aluminum and a backyard forge, and then sanded and painted with outdoor acrylic paint. The nail drop on the end of the necklace was handmade from 6-inch steel, a steel nail that was sanded and round, and I think she did a great job. Game of Thrones fans, make some noise for Sansa Stark. Coming out next, we have Cornetto Cosplay as Sabriel from the Old Kingdom series. Big round of applause for everybody. using Warbla, velvet, resin, vinyl, suede, leather, and chainmail. This costume was lovingly made between March and August using a knowledge of pattern making. It took over 250 hours and learning new skills for each single part of the costume. Sabria has been a lifelong love of Cardetta cosplay, and this costume is the realization of a childhood obsession. I was going to ask yourself, does the walker choose the path or the path choose the walker? Give it up for Sabriel. That's it, folks. Give those guys in that category a big round of applause. Big round of applause. Everyone did a great job. So, quick break here as we talk to the judges. Kelly, right off our needlework category there, and you work over at Singer Sewing. Are you guys excited about the fact that sewing and costuming and all that is really becoming on trend right now?
Absolutely. Sewing is such a great way to express your creativity, and I think cosplay just reinforces that.
Very cool, very cool. I like to see it. They did a great job. There was a lot of stuff like there that if you're sitting in the crowd, or maybe you can see it up on the screen, there was a lot of detail, because it takes a lot of hard work to get to this stance. Because you guys were walking the con all day. There's a lot of cosplayers out there, okay? But these folks out here are championship cosplayers, and they're bringing it to you guys. So give them all a big round of applause, okay? What's next? Coming up next is our FX category. I love the name Cow Butt Crunchies as Seraphim. Come on out, very nice job. Seraphim features techniques from not just one, but all three categories. The highly embezzled Warbler armor is handcrafted. Oh, she's still giving it to the people. Give it to the people. 2,000 feathers, 40 feet of aluminum, 3 motors to make up the 6 articulated wings, which open and close with a push of a button from the cosplayer's illuminated staff. This costume took over 300 hours to construct, and it weighs roughly 40 pounds, okay? Give her a big round of applause, everybody. That was fantastic. 40 pounds. All right, coming out next, we have Dan Lexi as Iron Man Mark 41 Bone Suit. This is from Iron Man 3. Again, the bone suit, he spent 331 hours making an Iron Man suit that was in the movie for a mere 12 seconds. Again, he was able to get this much detail from watching a 12-second clip of the movie. Give it up for Iron Man Mark 41 Bone Suit. Coming up next, we have Blazlin cosplaying as Blade Craft Oriana. Big round of applause. The costume took 300 hours to create, includes a bit of everything from armor to LEDs to sewn pieces to robotics. Wow. The armor was crafted from Warbler. The sewn pieces would include the ball with the character holes was 3D printed in primes. An entire army of robotics made inside it to move different directions. I don't even realize there are so many motors on this costume. It is absolutely ridiculous. You don't know where you're going. Uh-oh, she's blind. Come on back, come on back. Just come on back. Don't die, don't die, don't die. I have no insurance, and they're trying to get rid of Obamacare. You got to be very careful, be very careful. Come on this way. Okay, I ain't. Ooh, ooh, that looked like a lawsuit. Ooh. Ooh, that looked like a lawsuit. Ooh, ooh, I ain't got no money. Ooh. All right, coming out next, we have Ink Cosplay as Doctor Strange. The Sorcerer's Degree for the Marvel Cinematic Universe. This costume took 7 months to create. All the props are made with LED lights. The cape is made up of 5 different poly fabrics and weighs about 5 pounds. Over 400 hours of detailing the pattern was done by hand. And I, for one, think he did a fantastic job. That's very nice. Giving a little flair, giving a little showmanship. That, my friends, is what cosplay is all about. Not just the cosplay, but the way they acted out as well. So one more time, give it up for Dr. Strange, everybody. Big round of applause. Nice job. Here we go, folks. We have Lady LC as the Statue of Liberty Weeping Angel. Doctor Who fans, make some noise, all right? Billy was a nurse and crafted this cosplay over 9 years' time. The mask was cut by hand and painted to achieve this design. The wig was hand-dyed and then painted to achieve the correct look. The tiara was cut, painted, and fixed with LED lights. The torch was created with LED lights. To avoid messy makeup, a morph suit was cut, and the upper body was painted and fingernails applied. Lastly, the toga was handcrafted to mimic the statue's garment. Matt Smith called this cosplay bloody brilliant. And I gotta echo what he said. It is bloody brilliant and freaking creepy. Yeah, don't look at it. Keep looking at it. Keep looking at it. Keep looking, keep looking, keep looking, keep looking, keep looking. Okay, she's gone. All right, you gotta always keep looking, man. They turn back on you, all right? coming up next, we have Cape Rock Cosplay as Amikami Brainiac. I think I got that right. Whoa. Whoa. Introducing this costume took Vera over 2,000 hours to construct, all right? Includes over 130 working LEDs. I'm going to go over here and help you. I'm going to go over here. Yeah, that's the problem. Uh-oh. I don't know if I want to. I mean, this is not a good look. Superman should not be helping Brainiac, but that's all right. We're going to help you out. In. We're going to help you out. In. But come on over here. Come on out here. The armor was constructed with resin, corded Robla. The cowl was hand-molded out of Veriflex and 30 and took care of 100 hours to sculpt. Making this costume was not only Kara's first time soldering and wiring LEDs, but it was also her first time sculpting and casting a prosthetic and working with special effects and makeup. Let me explain to you this. First time sculpting, first time soldering, first time wiring LEDs, first time doing special effects makeup, first time cosplayer out here killing it. A big round of applause. We're gonna get you. I'm gonna help you again. Oh, I ain't scared of you. I ain't scared of you, Brainiac. All right, we can reach you this way. We're going. There you go. You don't see nothing. Just walk. Distraction. It's my distraction. She didn't even notice it. All right. Is that it? That was it. One more time, give our cosplayers a big round of applause, everybody. Man. So, ladies, it's that time. It's that time. So what we're going to do is we're going to send you guys to the back here in just a few moments. You are going to have the very, very tough job of crowning somebody a champion tonight. So what's going through your head right now? We're going to actually ask Stephanie. Stephanie, what's going through your head right now?
Oh, a lot of costumes.
Yeah.
I'm really grateful that we had a chance to prejudge because they've been a little bit more cemented in my head than they might have been if this is the first time I was seeing them. I'm really grateful for that. But we have a lot of decisions to make. We have to weigh a lot of aspects of each costume and think about them and really try to be as fair.
Well, Leanna, you're a cosplayer by trade. Now, does the performance also play out in your decision making?
Definitely. In the judging and the prejudging, we kind of had an idea of the direction we wanted to go in, but we knew that it's not set in stone, that once we see them on the stage, that can make or break your decision, or it can, you know, move someone up or bump someone down. So it's really important to see them on stage as well.
Very cool. And quick question, Kelly, if you ever had the dream of cosplaying as anybody, who would it be? Uh-oh.
What was the question one more
time? If you got the opportunity to cosplay as anyone, who would you cosplay as?
Oh, for myself?
Yeah.
I was actually really thinking about doing Leanna Mormont.
Yeah, do it. Why not? Why not? Very cool. Last but not least, Ashley, you've been on the panel before. You're an old hat at this. What are you looking for tonight out of these folks in the back?
You know, similar to what Leanna said, for me it is about performance because, you know, cosplay, as all of you know, you've been out on the floor all day. You're supposed to, you know, be able to walk around the con in it and show off and pose. And so we got to see up close. We got to see all the detail. And trust me, it's incredible. Every single chain link that you saw was hand done. Every single bead was hand done. So we got to see that aspect. But then we wanted to see their performance on stage. So it's tough because I do think some of our decisions might have been changed based upon that.
One more time, give our judges a big round of applause. Ladies, we have to say goodbye because you ladies got to go to the back and make a decision. One more time, give our judges a big round of applause, everybody. One more time, folks, we need to give a round of applause to all of our sponsors. One more time, give it up for Singers, G Fuel, and McCall's. Give them all a big round of applause, everybody, for sponsoring this fantastic event. Ashley is putting this on Snapchat, so make some noise for Ashley right now so you can be on TV. That's how you do it. All right, here we go. This is what we're going to do. Just a few moments, we're going to bring all the folks from one single category back on up. We're then going to announce the top three of that category. We're going to let all of them go away, and then we're going to announce our top three overall. One more time, give it up for our first category. Give it up for the armor category. Hold on, let's get them all on stage here. You know what? Get your cameras ready. Get your cameras ready. Before we announce the top three, pose off. Give me some poses, folks. Break it down for us. Give us some poses. Look good for the bride. There it is. Pose off. There it is. There it is. Pose off for us, folks. There you go. Nice job. Nice job. And now, my friends, it is time to do this thing. Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, drum roll, please. Thank you. Third place. Give it up for Rattle and Burn as Savannah's wind runner. Big round of applause, everybody. That was almost a mistake. In second place, Brittany Gonzalez, Yoshimitsu! And first place in the armor category, give it up for Mike Cameron as Orcus Wasteland Raider! Give them all a big round of applause, everybody! There you go. We're gonna get a nice picture for the photo guys there. There you go. Pose it down. Pose it down. Top three of the category, my friends. One more big round of applause for him, everybody. Give it up for our next category. Again, it's the needlework category. Big round of applause for them as they hit the stage. This is a tough category. Folks in the needlework, pose off. Give me some poses, folks. Give me some poses. Pose it down. Pose it down, ladies and gentlemen. Give us some great poses. There it is. Pose it down. Nice job. Once again, drum roll, please. Drum roll, please, people. There it is. In third place, Albino Shadow as Amira. Big round of applause for everybody. Big round of applause. Second place, Mabel Taylor. In first place for our needlework category, All Chemical Cosplay as Astrologian! Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. Only shooting stars break the mold. It's a cool place, and they say it gets colder. You're bubbled up now. Get those picks in now, my friends. Top three in the needlework category. Nice job, ladies. Head on this way. There you go. And now, clap and scream for our next category. Give it up for the FX category. FX category, pose down, my friends, pose down. There it is. Give us some poses. There you go. Pose it up. Look good for the camera. There it is. All right, folks. In the FX category, in the third place, give it up for Capra as Brady. In second place, Dan Lexi as Iron Man! In first place for the FX category, it is someone who did a great job in their own stage. Give it up for Cowboy Crunchies as Seraphim!
elbows down, my friends. One more time, give him a big round of applause. Everybody, big round of applause for him. Folks, it's time. It is time to crown best in the show. All right? Before we do that, I want to introduce you guys somebody special. He's hanging out in the wings over there. Where is Philip Odango? Philip Odango, Philip Odango in the wings somewhere. Where's Philip? There he is. Give it up for Philip, everybody. Philip is the singer brand ambassador. Give him a big round of applause. He's a cosplayer himself. Just want to talk to you real quick. Philip, so not only are these folks going to get a check from here at the Cosplay Championship, what do you have in your hand as well?
Well, as sponsors of this year's Eastern Championship of Cosplay, Singer is really excited to see all the amazing cosplays. So let's give them all a round of applause. And so this year, to celebrate our top three winners, Singer is going to be giving our top three winners a $1,000 shopping spree at singerstore.com.
Oh, very cool. So a nice little bonus. So you hang out over here with me as we announce our winners. So we're going to give them a giant check and another check as well for themselves. So here we go, my friends. Top three. Best in show. Now this is the big one, okay? So we're going to really show them some love, okay? So coming out the back. Best in show, third place, is Cowbutt Crunchies at Seraphim!
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. Only shooting stars break the mold. It's a cool place, and they say it gets colder. You're bundled up now, wait till you get older.
Here we go.
The world's on fire. How about
in
yours?
Second place.
That's the way I like it and I'll never get bored.
Mike Cameron as Organus Wasteland Raider.
Just don't breathe, man. Just don't breathe.
All right. For this one, it's our first place. And I'm going to need y'all to show them some love. When I announce this person, I need you all to act like you have a rocket ship in your booty and shoot up out of your seat, okay? Lose your rabbit ass minds, okay? First place. Alchemical Cosplay as Astrologia!
Champions, lose us, 'cause we are the champions.
One more. There you go. Hold those tracks up. You got to flip it over. There you go. Get those pictures in now, folks. They did a fantastic job. They have worked hard. They worked serious hours to come before you and show them their artwork. Give it up for our cosplay champions. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with us. I hope you guys had a great time. Look around yourself and grab your belongings. Anything you leave here, you will find on eBay. Thanks for hanging out. Have a great rest of your night. Bye.